read on his touch, and now into the corner once more. Space Station starting to pressure, starting to threaten. As Arsenal drops it to Sipical. Can he find AXP? The pass is good. The shot is good as well. And game one goes to Space Station.
Beautiful bit of possession here. Look at Arsenal, the small touch back to Sipical, and then he can control it in the corner for AXB. They just got to put him away.
They definitely were able to stay even, go toe-to-toe with them here, but in the beginning of game two, AXB picks it up off a defender, puts it up for 90, and they've got the lead.
And Sipical, he continues that trend of a beautiful challenge off the goalkeeper, just back towards
Sipical's got this one now. And Arsenal will look for the counter clear. A nice interception from Rapid, but AXB quickly up. Sipical holds Seabass to the side, and AXB will score 2-0 now for Space Station.
And this is so unfortunate. I like the cut-in rotation from Rapid to get in front of the clear, because that could have spawned a great counterattack. But the
and now through Rapid. Seabass on his backboard, not going to make contact. Rapid leaves it. Here comes Arsenal. Sends one towards the goal, but counter-touched all the way down. And that's Flight finally on the board.
Off the demo from Memory. He's just running back. Takes out that third man rotating in. Not even sure if he could have had enough speed to get that huge clear. Great.
Nothing's there. Now Sipical. Out Rapid with a response. Flight starting to gain control. Can Rapid find the double tap? Doesn't need to. Oh, it's off to the side. Seabass's shot was good. The defense couldn't quite get in the way, and we've got a tie game.
I'm not quite sure what happened. AXB, he just missed off the backboard. He had to get a better read. And then as he's coming down off the back.
Sipical now into an empty backfield. Can they find a way to get it around this retreating defense? That's through one. It's there in front of the box. Here's AXB. He puts it in. SSG takes the lead right back.
This was outstanding from Sipical. Look at the patience, and you saw the little stutter step to fake out the defender on the backboard.
Looks for a shot, puts it off the backboard twice. Now Seabass up,
Rapid,
who actually gets it into the box, and the redirection from Seabass. What a shot, and what a game.
This is great bit of passing right here. He just drops it directly down, and Seabass, he decides not to rotate out. Great decision-making, seeing an individual plays from Sipical.
Here comes AXB underneath one. Didn't get a flip reset, but it doesn't matter. Sipical's there to finish it off, and that's two overtimes in a row for Space Station.
AXB can do it all, and then the bit of patience. We saw Sipical do it on the backboard. AXB does it in the air. Clutch out of series.
Well, first 30 seconds. Both teams will have a few opportunities here. A pinch in the midfield will go in. Arsenal plays it off the defender. And the 425 at Space Station back up.
Seabass tried to hit Rapid early on. Rapid, he just needs to get up a little bit quicker and have a change of redirection with that ball.
Got one demolition. Arsenal onto the wall. Sipical with an open net. The demolition's good, and his teammate tries to steal it from him. But that's two now for Space Station.
Back-to-back passing, AXB with a great demo. Arsenal, he notices his positioning. He knows that AXB's player that we see pop off, get some nice flicks over the defenders. But none of that is really coming out and into fruition right now as Space Station are still aggressive. Seabass can't do anything. And Space Station, they're just popping off.
Oh, they just pin him against the air to say, you have to be over here. I'm sorry, you're not allowed to play Rocket League today. Just let him take the free shot. 3-0 for SSG. Well, 27 seconds left.
If you're going to save your own goals, and then, okay, there it is. Arsenal is just going to end it.
Puts it all the way in. A hat trick for Arsenal here is Space Station make simple work of Flight. The demolition in the midfield absolutely guarantees the shot going in. I mean, it was probably going to go in no matter what. And yeah, no, I mean, Space.
Back off the backboard. Jack's just up again. It looks like it's going to be the first chance to come over for Sonics, and they make the most of it.
Shock, this man can hit a shot from any angle. He goes off the corner wall, flips his car upside down, beats out Roldiz, who would you'd assume he'd be a little bit shocked to do these amazing 1v1 shooting plays and dribbles. Sathu's there for some cleanups. Everything is great, but what off the backboard? How did this go in?
It's one of those ones, it looked so weird. I'm assuming it's not gonna get any weirder or less weird. Yep, Oxer with a double tap. Not too sure, spot it so far. Now the shock off the backboard. He's looking to follow, and he's gonna nail it.
Shock looking for another player of the day, MVP. Shock off the backboard. He reads it better than the defender again. That's his second goal.
He wins the challenge. Rolled it. It's going to be awkward for him. Has to play it early. New staff, you want the demo, and Shock couldn't get over the top of the ball. Follow-up will be enough, though.
I love this touch from Shock. He could have easily gone for the attempt on getting a goal above the ball, but he knew the probability of getting that shot and landing is so much harder. Instead, he trusts Dapper.
Hawks on the backboard. Didn't get a touch he was after, though. It's going to require roll this. Only as far as the midfield. That's a lot of boost juice. Huge demo. And those plays are just running roughshod over E United.
This is what won the series earlier for Sonics, was Dapper crashing the net, getting a great demo.
Safi with the challenge might be able to find a way out. No, not quite. Rolled is with the follow. Good off speed. The backboard. Dapper jumps.
That's it.
And it will be scored.
You talked about it earlier, Shogun. You need to be faster on that initial challenge. And Roldis, listen, he was so speedy to get up to that ball, beat out Dapper in the backfield, and that's what opened up everything.
We saw them start to do a lot during last year, very early on, where they would just make a sweeping play. His Shock on target, 13 seconds remaining. Is that going to be enough?
I mean, speaking of sweeping plays, Dapper sweeps this ball all the way across to Shock. They've been a great duo all season long.
And Sonics find themselves on defense to start off the game. Dapper, though, he has been stalwart throughout this entire series. Looks for those demos already and opens up the gap. Sonics continue exactly where they left off.
My goodness, Dapper, he got the first demo. And if that wasn't enough, he actually went for the second man rotating back. Just a pillar of success for this Sonics roster.
It feels like if you're E-United and you're still on the field, it is an insult as there's another demo, another goal. Sonics, we were talking all about pressure. We were talking that this was going to be difficult. They laugh
literally
in the face of all of it.
The demos back and forth, Safi, but they're just not fast enough. We want to see better speed from Hoxer right here. He's got a double touch in the corner. What's he going to do with it? A big miss, but Ajax is there for the finish and a great first start here, finally in game three.
Hold on, here we go. Hoxer not getting contact was probably the best thing for this play. Everybody starting to crowd around looking to try and take the... Looks to finish it, everybody jumping. Dapper actually goes in and he gets contact. If he didn't do that, it was going to leave their defense in a 2v1. Safu, though, might have just sealed it.
E-United have been forced time and time again in these awkward situations. Sonics, beautiful rotations around the ball, hammering the net.
Number one, G2 earlier on today for a win through Sonics, able to confirm their playoff spots, but Ghost Gaming trying to chase down their own, and it's going to be a fantastic start. Missed, puts them one up.
Banger of a shot. Rizzo can't really get one cleanly into the middle because Atomic just goes right for it, and Chicago, as he's jumping off the backboard, doesn't have any boost.
Well, that is.
Down, JNaps for the double tap, leaves it, and Rizzo finally, after over 6 minutes, has got G2 a goal.
Yeah, Chicago just gets in Illusion's face, and again, there's that touch up towards the backboard. I think Miz thought Atomic was going to have maybe a better chance at getting it. And G2 on transition, looking for JNaps for Rizzo, and will he get there? Middle of the goal, there's Chicago waiting for it, and there's a block. Number three comes through, JNaps will turn it in. And G2 finally just send too many people for them to handle.
I was going to say exactly that. How many players is enough?
Instead of getting on top of it and can't find that third touch, Mist will drill one into the middle, and Chicago on the goal line. And looking for Atomic, and what a selfless pass from Illusion.
Yeah, just very round after round offense from Illusion. Just dumps that to Atomic, and if you're G2, often find Ghost Gaming trying to travel backwards with their aerials, but it's working out just fine each and every time. Drop up, here's JNaps! Into the top corner!
Chicago, beautiful setup here. He realizes no one from Ghost up, and instead of going towards the backboard and let Illusion get a chance at it first, he just pops it. The right move to back off, and a huge challenge from Illusion. Chicago needs to buy time, and that's awkward for G2. They gotta stare at this one, and he'll get it! Miss turns it into the lower right-hand side.
Like a cannon, straight into the back of the net. Missed! Gives them no chance. What a hit that is. Just out of the way of JNaps.
Ooh, and Rizzo is forced to tip that ball into the corner, and Ghost make a possession out of this.
Oh, yep. Rizzo also misses on target! Ghost Gaming, a minute and a half away from victory.
G2 beats one, but there's Mist. I said it back at the start of the series. He's going to have to fill the gaps.
Find a goal. See it drop down. Mist. He wins the ball. Will there be anyone there? Rizzo can't make it. 2-0.
Rizzo can't make it because JNaps just straight whiffs the ball. And Chicago tries to cover up, and Rizzo's expecting to have time to go grab Boost in the opposite corner. Chicago.
That clock is certainly ticking down. 5 seconds remaining. Ghost Gaming with a statement victory to their resume as Rizzo puts one more in, and it was a great goal at that, but it will not be enough. Ladies and gentlemen, we have no more undefeated teams in the RLCS as Ghost Gaming will take down G2.
Oh, and he blocks the shot from his teammate, and now Wonders got a free goal! Oh, no! And Wonders says, oh, yes, Rogue have the lead.
AJ was floating through the air. He had no boost. He couldn't really get out of the way. That is unfortunate.
And that's, I believe, Wonders' third demo. So Rogue getting really physical. First killer got chipped, but he'll put this in it! First killer puts the second in for Rogue.
I love this from First Killer, a quick turn. Gyro tried, it looked like Gyro wanted to jump for the bump on First Killer, but First Killer just play from First Killer. And that gets Rogue their second goal, a very important one, a side flip from First Killer, however, and that's gonna hurt them. So after getting the goal, First Killer makes a mechanical mistake and Gyro gets the goal right over it.
And a nice touch from Gyro, but like you said, AJ trying to chase it down with no boost. First killer has lead on the ball. He saw Wonder downfield. He's got him. Crow's there. Crow has a goal, and that's a 3 point for Rogue.
Gorgeous play. Wonder is deep in enemy territory, and First Killer throws it all the way up to him, using Wonder as the backboard.
Oh, Wonder just hops right in front. These challenges are really difficult for the Knights. You can tell their positioning just not ready for it. It is in! Oh, Carnovi will put it in off of the pass from Wonder. Or not Wonder, First Killer.
First Killer. First Killer gets the double tap. It's close enough to make Reddles he lurks back towards net
as it's taken away by First Killer. So despite Rogue having a huge chance, the Knights come right back and Reddles will pick up the goal.
And this is a textbook give and go. Reddles to Gyro. Reddles jumps immediately. It was the perfect pass.
First killer having to avoid a bump and now coming up has the challenge, but Reddles wins this. Now the Knights are starting to win some 50-50s and Reddles puts his second in.
The Knights come roaring back. Gyro with the challenge, Reddles comes in and pokes it by the defense, and then Krenovi misses the challenge, leaving Reddles with it for the Knights. Two goals, sitting at over 400 points this game. Doing work.
Oh, and Wonder will put this in. No one from the Knights was able to pick up this rebound. And James, I was about to say, this could be where it gets dangerous for Rogue because they're known to let games get away from them on defense. And once a team, I see his name more often than not, stopping the ball in midfield. He misses this, and it's a shot, and it will go in off the miss from First Killer. So AJ gets the lead back for the Knights.
And this is a huge play. First Killer, he got a touch, but it went backwards. He was even spinning on his way up, perhaps
all over the pitch, even in losses. There's so many times you're watching Reddles play and you're like, man, this guy is all over the place. How about the pass from AJ, but then the miss, and Reddles will convert. The Knights have the lead.
It was on cue, Jorby. You're talking about Reddles and his speed. He looks for this rebound, comes in, and hammers that ball to the far post.
Another demo on Wonder. Krenovi had pitched that off the ramp looking for Wonder. Here the flip off for AJ. The shot is good. Reddles puts another in. It's AJ to Reddles. The connection is solid.
AJ, he started that bounce air dribble play with full boost. You know he's going to do some damage. Fades out the double commit. You have to give AJ credit as well. That flip reset shot was huge. And now
yeah,
an opportunity. Open net for Gyro, and he'll sink that one in.
3-0, 25 seconds left. The Knights secure this game.
And First Killer needed to find a way to get that ball out. The blueprint is there for Rogue. It's just they can't seem to put it together consistently. Will they put one in? First Killer will get a goal at the end of game number three, but it's the Knights who take series advantage, James.
They take it, and this is the only goal that Rogue got, coming at 0 seconds when it doesn't really mean anything.
Drastic trying to kill this ball. It's Reddles flipping up on the short hop air dribble. Reddles almost makes it, and Gyro will convert. The Knights in the lead yet again.
Even though Reddles doesn't get credit for this goal, look at this play. Takes First Killer out. Completely paves the way for Gyro to
jump back quickly for a save. The Knights back. AJ, woo, Gyro actually got in front of AJ for that save. Another shot for Krenovi, and it's in. Krenovi will tie the game for Rogue.
And a good pass from Wonder off the backboard as well. Getting to that ball first, floating it up. Gyro was on empty. Couldn't make the save. AJ.
Reddles trying to keep it away. Rogue feeling pressure from the Knights, but they hang on. First Killer, no boost. Back over to Wonder. Wonder slowed it down in front of the box, and it goes under! And Wonder keeps Rogue in the series!
The Wonder undershot. First Killer had no boost, so that's the only challenge he could do. And you could see him just playing
in position for those. It's okay to slow down a little bit. The game feels a little fast for him right now, and it's good for First Killer! Disaster on defense for the Knights!
And this was AJ. He jumps in front of Gyro, who's going to get this save potentially. It still might have snuck his way in. Gyro. Squishy may be going for the double tap, but as soon as he recognized the trajectory wasn't there, he went for the challenge, and it was a good thing because there was a shot coming in, just like another one. Gimmick with the cleanup, and Cloud9 strike first.
This is a good carry from Torment. Flicks it right by Justin, baited him up, and then Garrett, a tough save. He had to jump straight up onto the line, and it ended up.
Cloud9 is matching up well against NRG, but they've got to hold on. Double commit. Turbo's got a shot, and Turbo hits it. Devastating strike for Cloud9 as Turbo erases their lead in the blink of an eye.
Well, it was almost clean.
Garrett has to read it. He didn't. And Torment couldn't read it off the backboard. That was a golden opportunity. And now Squishy,
oh, Squishy
finishes the job himself. What a play.
Oh, Squishy, this is exactly what you expect from Squishy Muffins. Perfectly placed into the corner. The defender in the middle of the net.
Dunk allowed everyone from NRG to get fully boosted up. However, we're not seeing as much dynamic passing. Now Squishy gets a pass from Gimmick. And this is like we've stepped into a time machine. Gimmick and Squishy working together, taking it to NRG.
That carry from Gimmick was so good. And from another long clear, NRG are just desperate to get control of midfield because they've struggled for it. And Garrett, a huge whiff, and Torment will punish. Uncharacteristic whiff from Garrett.
Yeah, you see there, Gimmick getting a hard hit, and Garrett was just a split second off on his. That's it. That's the only stat NRG has managed to accumulate so far. It's a single shot. Now a save coming out from Garrett.
Against Cloud9, who pick up a third goal. This is a team trying to fight their way out of 10th place, and they're bringing it to one of the best teams in North America.
I like how Gimmick doesn't even flip into that.
And now Cloud9 potentially are going to go up 2-0 in this series against NRG. And they're going to get a fourth goal. And there's 2 minutes and 19 seconds left, and I'm ready to call the game.
And this is brutal. NRG is getting destroyed. The pass off the backboard from Gimmick. Torment cleans it up.
Chasing this. Couldn't find the touch. Gimmick will carry it away, and that 50 will go right over to his teammate. Turbo has to make the save, and he can't do it. Squishy will get credit for the goal, but Turbo, the miss.
It goes right to Squishy. Turbo's racing back. And that was a tough ball due to the challenge. And Turbo couldn't get back in time.
Quick pass, but it's wide. Turbo wants it. And finally, NRG, for the first time in over 7 minutes, have a goal.
And Garrett puts the shot wide, gets the bump. That clears the way. If he goes right for net,
the play would have been to maybe try to take a shot, maybe go for a backward pass regardless. We've got Cloud9 on the other end. Squishy, the air dribble!
I was wondering, as soon as he took this up in the air, he somehow finds a way to score the simplest air dribbles, but it's just really two taps, James. It's barely an air carry. It's just forced the whole way back after a massive clear from Torment. Torment, a shot on net, but it's just wide. And another gimmick scores, and it's insurance for Cloud9 late.
This is unbelievable. Torment hits it over to the middle. Turbo can't get to the ball. It hits off the post.
It's unfortunate for Turbo, but fortune favors Cloud9, but here come NRG. It's not over. Justin will punch one in with 22 seconds remaining. Hope is not lost.
Hope is not lost after this goal. Turbo very speedy to that. Justin was low on boost, but...